Very good morning, dear students. Before the start of the class, let us take a pledge to fight the deadly coronavirus. I, Harper Singh, commit to be vigilant and bear in mind at all times the risk to myself and my colleagues from COVID-19. I promise to take all necessary precautions that prevent the spread of this deadly virus. I promise to follow and encourage others to follow the COVID-19 appropriate behavior. To always wear a mask, face cover, especially when in public places. To maintain a minimum distance of 6 feet from others. To wash my hands frequently and thoroughly with soap and water. And together, by taking all these precautions, we will win this fight against COVID-19. Today in this AV, we will continue with some more questions from exercise 7C, which are based on properties of proportions. So let us start with one more question of exercise 7C, question number 11. So we will take question number 11. In this question, we have to solve using properties of proportion for x. So there are various expressions which we need to solve for x. So let us take first expression. It is root x plus 5 plus root x minus 16 over root x plus 5 minus root x minus 16 is equal to 7/3. So here we have to solve this using properties of proportions. So let us start with the solutions. How we will take this sum? So it is solve for x. This expression, root x plus 5 plus root x minus 16 over root x plus 5 minus root x minus 16 is equal to 7/3. So here, if same terms occur in addition and subtraction in numerator and denominator, agar same number plus or minus occur aate hain, then we can apply componendo and dividendo. Apply componendo and dividendo both together. So it will be root x plus 5 plus root x minus 16 plus root x plus 5 minus root x minus 16 over root x plus 5 plus root x minus 16 minus root x plus 5 minus root x minus 16 is equal to 7/3/7-3. So this implies root x plus 5 plus root x minus 16 plus root x plus 5 minus root x minus 16 over. अब जब डिनोमिनेटर में हम ब्रैकेट ओपन करेंगे तो देर इज अ नेगेटिव साइन इन बिटवीन द टू ब्रैकेट्स, सो वी कैन चेंज द साइन ऑफ सेकेंड ब्रैकेट. तो इट विल बिकम रूट एक्स प्लस 5 प्लस रूट एक्स माइनस 16 माइनस रूट एक्स माइनस 5 प्लस रूट एक्स माइनस 16 एंड राइट हैंड साइड 7/3 = 10, 7-3 = 4. And in the numerator, root x minus 16 have opposite sign. Isko cancel kar dijiye. In denominator, root x plus 5 minus root x minus 5 will get cancelled. So root x plus 5 plus root x plus 5, it is twice root x plus 5. And similarly, denominator is twice root x minus 16. And right hand side, 10/4, we can cancel it on 2. It will be 5/2. And here this 2 can also be cancelled. Now we will have one single term containing square root. So iska square root khatam karne ke liye we will square both sides. Squaring both sides, we get x plus 5 over x minus 16. Their square root will get cancelled. Or we will write like this also. Is equal to 5/2². Now after squaring, square root get cancelled, so it is x plus 5 over x minus 16 and right hand side square of 5 is 25, square of 2 is 4. Now cross multiply, it is 4x plus 20, 25x minus 16 into 25, it will be 25 into 16, 6 into 5 30, 80, then it is 32, it is 400. minus 400. Now shift term containing x to the left hand side. So 4x minus 25x is equal to minus 400 minus 20. 4 minus 25x, it is minus 21x is equal to minus 420. So negative sign will get cancelled from both the side. So it means x is equal to 420 over 21. Now 21 2s are 42, so it means x is equal to 20. So therefore in this way, by applying the properties of proportions, we can solve any expression for x. So here in this expression, what we had done, we apply componendo and dividendo, then squaring both sides, and afterward on cross multiplying and simplifying, we will get x is equal to 20. So in this way, we can solve any given expression by using properties of proportions. So in this way, we can solve other problems using properties of proportion in the same way. In some problem, we need to apply componendo, dividendo. In some problem, we need to apply alternando. In some problem, we need to apply only componendo, in some only dividendo, etc. And by using these all things, we can solve all the problems. So I hope this AV will help you to solve all the problems of this exercise from question number 10 to 10 onward. So we will see how to solve some other problems also. For this, we will take another question. Now let us take question number 15. In question number 15, he said x cube plus 3xy square over 3x square y plus y cube is equal to m cube plus 3mn square over 3m square n plus n cube, and here we need to show nx is equal to my. So this is question number 15th. In question number 15, we are given with x cube plus 3xy square over 3x square y plus y cube is equal to m cube plus 3mn square over 3m square n plus n cube, and we need to prove nx is equal to my. So now here you can see, firstly you can observe that both the sides are identical, only difference is at the place of x we have m in right hand side, and at the place of y we have n. Other thing is exactly similar. So again here we can apply componendo and dividendo. Apply componendo and dividendo. It will be x cube plus 3xy square plus 3x square y plus y cube over x cube plus 3xy square minus 3x square y plus y cube, and similarly on right hand side it will be m cube plus 3mn square plus 3m square n plus n cube over m cube plus 3mn square minus 3m square n plus n cube. Now open the brackets, it will become x cube plus 3xy square plus 3x square y plus y cube over x cube plus 3xy square minus 3x square y minus y cube, and right hand side is m cube plus 3mn square plus 3m square n plus n cube over m cube plus 3mn square minus 3m square n minus n cube. So if you observe, it is the formula for a plus b whole cube and a minus b whole cube. So it will become x plus y whole cube over x minus y whole cube, and right hand side will be m plus n whole cube over m minus n whole cube. Now take cube root both sides. It will become, on taking cube root both sides, the cube is cancelled. So it will become x plus y over x minus y is equal to m plus n over m minus n. Now here again we can apply componendo and dividendo. So again apply componendo and dividendo. So it will become x plus y plus x minus y over x plus y minus x minus y is equal to m plus n plus m minus n over m plus n minus m minus n. So it means x plus y plus x minus y over x plus y minus x plus y is equal to m plus n plus m minus n over m plus n minus m plus n. So in numerator on left hand side y cancel, on right hand side n cancel, in denominator left hand side x cancel and right hand side m cancel. So it become 2x over 2y is equal to 2m over 2n. Now cancel 2 of each side. Now cross multiply. So it is nx is equal to my. This is what we need to prove. So therefore by applying the properties we can solve or we can prove anything. So I hope this AB will help you again to solve the other problems also. Thank you very much for watching this AB.